Welcome back to MBA Monday. I'm Angela Guido, the founder of Career Protocol, and today I'm talking about how to get into Wharton. If you're following along in our School Secrets series, you already know that I don't think there is any such thing as secrets. And you've probably also noticed a trend that what most business school essays are really about is not your professional career. It's not how awesome you are. It's about who you are on the inside. So your values and your character are critically important evaluation criteria for every top business school. And Wharton has been quite innovative, true to their brand, true to their commitment to innovation. They've been quite innovative in figuring out unique ways to assess student character that is a little bit different from what most top MBA programs are doing. So let's see what we need to do as we're tackling the Wharton MBA application. Number one is you want to make sure that you have a rock star resume. That means ideally you've had a lot of impact. You've achieved a lot. You've been promoted. You've gotten awards. You're just kind of like an awesome all-around person. But whatever you have to work with in your career, and plenty of people who get into Wharton are not rock stars per se, they're just solid professionals. They're just people doing great work. So whatever you have to show for your career, make sure that it's expressed fully in the resume by applying Career Protocol's 3 tests for your resume. Click the link in the description below to read the MBA resume protocol. It will save your life. It will really improve your resume. And your resume is really important for Wharton, because when you get into the essays, you're gonna see you have much less space here than you do in a lot of the other top schools. And the questions are very targeted. So you're not gonna be able to work your own agenda at all. You're gonna have to directly answer the questions that Wharton is asking. And if you try to veer off and talk about what a rock star you are, it's not gonna work. So put all of that in the resume so that when you tackle the essays, you can really just answer the questions they're asking. Question number one, okay? So the second piece of applying to Wharton that's really, really important is to have an amazing career game plan. We talk about this a lot on our channel because it's so, so, so important, but the entire first Wharton essay is all about your future. It's all about your career game plan. The question is, what do you hope to gain professionally at Wharton? It's all about where you're headed professionally and how Wharton is gonna help you. Now, this doesn't mean that you might not mention one or two accomplishments when you're tackling this essay. That is a strategy that a lot of people employ, and it can be very effective, especially if your goals are really grounded in what you've done before. But the essence of this question is checking out your career game plan. They're looking for employability, credibility in your plan, and inspiration. As always, schools want to be inspired by where you're headed and what you're going. They want to know that they're investing their seat in someone who is going to matter and make a difference. So that's essay one. Essay two is actually in a lot of ways similar. They're still asking you to talk about your experience at Wharton, but this time they're asking you how you're going to contribute. So the question is, taking into consideration your background, personal, professional, and/or academic, how do you plan to make specific, meaningful contributions to the Wharton community? This essay is a little bit shorter than the first one, 400 words as opposed to 500. And of course, they're not asking you why Wharton or how is Wharton gonna contribute to you. They're asking, how do you wanna contribute to Wharton? So in this essay, you will talk about past experiences, making contributions, and you'll show them how those are going to map to the Wharton community. So you need to do lots of research on clubs, organizations, activities, ways in which you're gonna make your mark when you are at Wharton. Even the Wharton recommendation questions are subtly different from other top programs because they're really, really focused on how Wharton fits in, how you're going to fit in to Wharton. So keep all of that in mind as you're tackling those two main essays, because the truth is, Wharton isn't really looking very closely at your character in those essays. You will hint at your character as you talk about what contributions you're going to make and how you will benefit professionally from a Wharton MBA. But the place where Wharton innovatively is truly assessing the kind of person you are is in their interview. And you may know that for many years now, Wharton has entirely eschewed a one-on-one conversation about you in favor of the team-based discussion. You're gonna get together with a group of fellow Wharton applicants and discuss a topic, collaborate, and come up with a plan of action to answer a question that Wharton is asking you. It's amazing what you reveal about yourself in group interactions. You show how collaborative you are, how inclusive you are, how much you respect and value the opinions of others, how focused you are on a solution versus argumentation or having your way or being right. So where Wharton is mostly assessing your character, it's not in the essays, it's actually in that interview. So that means that to even get to that stage where Wharton is entirely engaged in who you are as a complete human being, you've got to have a solid career game plan, a rockstar resume, and a very clear path to make an impact at Wharton and beyond. So, as is very frequently the case with MBA applications, make sure you have an airtight career game plan and an airtight resume. Check out all the resources we're linking below to help you do that. And while you're at it, subscribe to our channel, why don't you? We got great advice coming at you every Monday. Speaking of which, I'll see you next week. If you're following along in our School Secrets series, School Secrets,